Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to show you a beautiful dress design using flowers and leaves. I did this for a competition and I won first prize for the same. We be given guidelines like not to use any other things other than flowers and leaves. So this is the prize that I received. I'll show you the dress. This is it. Isn't it beautiful? A little bit of self-praising. Okay. So, I did not plan anything beforehand. I just gathered few flowers and leaves. And due to the pandemic, it was really hard for me to collect the flowers as I don't have much of flowers in my garden. So I went outside and bought few. Moving on to the body structure, I drew only the parts that were visible outside. I drew two hands that were stretching apart and a leg. And I developed the skin color using different shades of brown, pink and cream colors, because I didn't have a perfect skin color with me. These are normal Faber-Castell color pencils. I kept giving strokes and shadings and few shadows wherever necessary. Shadows are very important for body structure, that adds beauty to each and every part of it. So I rectified the mistakes that I already had in the eyes, in the eyebrows, etc. Moving on to the hair, I gave a dark brown color in the beginning and then I developed the color using other shades of brown. This way, I developed a perfect color for the hair that suits best with the outfit. So that's about the body part. Moving on to the arrangement of flowers and leaves. I did not have any preset plans for the outfit. To be honest, that's the best part. If you plan something, you wouldn't get it right. All I did was collecting few flowers and leaves as much as possible. So these are the things that I gathered. Cordyline rubra, it's the scientific name of this plant. And it is a leaf, beautiful leaf. And this is yellow marigold, which I bought from a shop. And I also bought globosa from a shop as well, but the globosa I kept arranging them, and I found that the globosa isn't going with the, it is not having any combination with the leaves or the flower, so I did not use it. I only used the marigold and the cordyline rubra. So moving on to the most important part, that is the rearrangement of flowers and leaves. I suggest you to rearrange the flowers and leaves at least 5 times. You can use scissors to cut them in desired shapes. Just try rearranging them in different ways, because each and every time you might get a new design. I kept arranging them. Do not throw away these small pieces that you get after cutting, because you may need them later. I gave the same color to the shoes as that of the upper body. and the lipstick is exactly as of the leaves that are used, so that there is a coordination between the lipstick, shoes and the outfit. Like I said before, small pieces that I've cut have been used here and it looks beautiful. I tried different ways like hairbands, necklaces, and it all looked absurd, so I removed them. And this is how it looks in the end. I placed a small piece of petal on the hair to give a more coordinated look to the outfit. The way the leaves stand makes it look so pretty that it looks kind of a flare of a gown. If you look closer, you can see that I've also placed ribbon using the leaves at the back. So this is how it looks. Hope you like it. Do not forget to like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel, and also follow my Instagram handles @Zania and @VogueZania. Thank you so much for watching.